myself Sangeeta Devi from GK Jain School. In today's class, we are going to see a commerce. In the before session and all, we have completed chapter 1. We are moving on to chapter number 2, functions of management. In the functions of management, we are going to see the classifications under these functions of management, why there is a need for the management functions, and what are its classifications, how it is being defined, everything we are going to see in today's session. So now, functions of management has been classified into two categories, main functions, subsidiary functions. Under the main functions, we have 7 categories to be discussed in deep about. Main function is very, very important for every management. They need to follow this 7 steps, then only they can achieve their organization goals. Management is the only thing what we need to do is achieve our goals by following all those steps. This is the steps we are going to follow. And in the subsidiary function, a subsidiary function is nothing, an additional function to the main function. Whatever the things in the English itself we will see in main class, subsidiary class, that is only the additional. Same way, this is the main points needs to be there in every organization. This is all the additional points where we can add it or not. In some companies, everywhere they will have this. Few companies, only they will have follow up this 7 points only. Now we are going to see what are these points. What are its explanations? Everything. First main functions. First point is planning. Planning is very, very important. For everything we need to plan. Today I am taking a class. For this also I need to plan how to take a class. Same way, if you are writing a book, you need to plan how you are going to start up. What are the content you are going to take into book. Everything we need to plan. Not only in the reading, writing, in that every field, everywhere you will see there's some person who is planning for their execution. If you go for a film, the director will plan first what shot needs to be taken, next what is going to be there. For everything, planning is very, very important. For a proverb itself we will have, look before you leap. Whatever you are going to do, do it. Think it before you are doing it. Then only you can do it, whatever in the perfect way. That is in the correct way you can do it. Otherwise you cannot do any work in a correct way. So planning is very, very important for every organization. They will plan what they are going to achieve. In this year, we have last year, they will compare. First they will compare. Okay, last year we have achieved 1000 units. Why don't we go for the next? In this year, we are going to increase the production. Last year we have 1000 units of production. Now this year you can plan it for 2000. So this is the increase why they are making, that they will plan. How they are going to execute, they need to plan. Because it is not an easy job for starting up the organization. Now we are going to see a small example. I have a factory in the house. A factory nearby the houses where the many number of people are there. I am going to start up a factory there. I need to decide how many workers I am going to involve, how much an amount of amount of cost of production is going to be taken, how much of employees needs for every machine. If I am going to hire a machine, I need 10 people, or two machines I am going. So I should decide and should plan everything in before. Planning is nothing, deciding in advance. It can be told as deciding in advance. Why I am writing this deciding in advance alone? For your writing an exam, you should write this key point. Because everywhere if you go and see the schools also, they will mention you with some keywords. Because while you are while the examiner is correcting your paper, they will see only the keywords. So you should give importance to the keywords. So planning, meaning is deciding in advance. If it is there, if I myself correct a paper, I will see only the keywords. Because I need to correct more number of papers at a day, I cannot see all the lines line by line. So I will give importance to these points. So keywords. So this planning is deciding in advance. Next we go for organizing. Organizing. Now organizing is that if I have decided, I have planned everything, I have made a schedule, this day this much of units needs to be produced, this much of works needs to be completed by the manager, everything I have planned. Now I need to organize that how the manager has decided and planned everything. Now the manager will divide the works. He has decided 2000 units needs to be produced this year, and for per day if he decides to produce 200 units, for example I am telling you 200 units he needs to plan to produce. So he needs to divide the work. If example let me take off a garment making, garment industries, they need to manufacture 100 shirts or 200 shirts if they decide. For that, who is going to, as a first thing, they will decide who is going to stitch a collar, who is going to stitch a hand, who is going to stitch a main part. So this they need to plan. How much of the unit can be done with the, this machine, machines, how much machine is required for making 100, 200 shirts per day. They need how much of machines, how much of employees, everything they have decided. So now they need to divide the works among the persons and give it to them, and they need to give them some authority also. If I'm not giving authority, nobody will be responsible for it. If I have given authority or something, I will be responsible to my work. For everything, the manager needs to be given some authority to supervisor that you are responsible for this work. Then only the supervisor will give their works to the subordinates and get the best from them. If example, I have already told you 200 units, 200 shirts they have planned to. So the supervisor will be given authority and responsibility to the work. Now the supervisor work is to get the work done by the subordinates and give the works to the manager. So when I give authority and responsibility to the person only, they will be responsible and give back the what work I have given and completed and give it. So that needs to be done only with the organizing. Every work needs to be made accountable. Every person needs to be made accountable. The manager is also accountable. Who to whom? He will be accountable to the top level management, board of directors or managing director. He will be responsible. So in that such a way, this organizing needs to be there in the main functions. Now next thing we are going on is staffing. Staffing. I have decided, I have divided the work also. That division of works needs to be done in a way that in such a way, one, if I have going to give a work of stitching a hand to a person, the person needs to know the work. Then only he will be doing it in a correct way. Otherwise, if I am not going to give it to the person in a correct way, correct right person I am not choosing, he will not do it because he do not know how to stitch a hand. I am giving a work, how can I get the work from them? So I should give the work to them in by knowing their quality, capacity, everything. Then only I can give the works and get the best out of them. So staffing is nothing. Right person needs to be selected and trained also. Training needs to be given to them. That is very, very important. Everyone do not have all the skills in them and come for the work. Everyone will be having their skills. And for our work, what needs, skills needs to be developed, we should give them some training. In such a way only we can get the staffing. Right persons needs to be selected for the right job. You will develop that in the staffing. Next thing we are going on is directing. Directing is nothing. We need to direct or lead them to the organizational goals. We are having the organizational goals. This organizational goals needs to be achieved with the help of directing only, because from manager, supervisor will get the direction. Direction in the meaning, this is our organizational goals, the goals they will direct, and next they will be giving it to subordinates. So in such a way the direction should be there by motivating them, by giving them suggestions, this needs to be done today, this is our work. For everywhere, wherever we are working, the higher authority will tell today it is your work, you need to complete it. In such a way the directing is very, very important. From the top level to the lower level, the direction needs to be given properly for their goals. Because I'm not telling their goals straight away to them, they will work leisurely, they will work slowly. If I tell them this is our goal, this needs to be done, so they will try to complete it. If they are not completing it also, they will try to complete. So that needs to be done only when it is direction is there, directing is there. Next is motivation. Motivation. For everyone, there should be a motivation. If an example, I'll tell you a very small example. If a mother wants to buy something, let me take off a milk packet. He tells to his son, go and buy a milk packet. He will never go. Only few persons will, whenever his sons are very good person, they will definitely go and buy a milk packet and come. If they are not, good at, the mother will motivate. If you go and buy a milk packet, I will cook something good for you and give. Otherwise, you can buy extra chocolate and eat. In such a way, her mother is motivating to send her sons to buy a milk packet. The same way, the organizational higher authorities, managing director, board of directors, manager needs to motivate every employees. That is very, very important. If they are not motivating employees, they will not even get the best work from them. So in order to motivate them, they should give incentives, bonus, monetary, it can be or non-monetary. It can be in a cash form or in a non-cash form, it can be. But they should give some motivation by such a way of giving incentive, bonus to the festivals. In that such a way, the motivation is very, very important. They should encourage their employees. You have the capacity, you should do it. In such a way, if they motivate them, we can get the best work from them. So that it will be easier for us to achieve our organizational goals. So motivation plays that role. Next is controlling. Controlling is that if I am doing my work, they have told me that 200 units need to be produced per day. I'm doing it for 3 months or 4 months. As a manager or as a higher authority, what they will do, they should compare their work with the other year, next year, previous year. They should compare with this year and find it out. In the last year, we have done 1,000 units. So per day, 100 shirts we have produced. Now this year, 2,000 units we are planning. So per day, 200 we are doing. Whether we are doing it 200 or 199, or why we are getting lagging, where we need to improve, where the actual performance we are getting best. They should see where is the problem they are arising. Why can we not complete it? In such a way, the questions will arise for the manager, so that he will control his employees by comparing the work. That is by the previous year with this year, and they will compare their work and get the best work from them. In such a way, the controlling will work. Actual performance. This keyword is actual performance. You need to write. Actual performance needs to be compared with the previous year in order to know the best work they have doing or not. So in order to know it, you should compare your performance. Next is coordination. Coordination is very, very important for all the other 6 points. The 6 points, the coordination should be there. If we are lacking coordination, no works cannot be done. For everything, the coordination is very, very important. Why in the case I'm telling you, planning, coordination should be there. If the managing director is planning, they should have coordination with the manager. And planning, they should involve everybody and plan. This year, this much of workers are there, they are able to do it or not. We should plan. For organizing also, in this work needs to be divided. I should call the supervisor and subordinate. He is having different capability. For every person, capacity is different. Each one will be having capacity. If I take example, there are 3 person. One can stitch 100 shirts per day. One can stitch 250 shirts also. One can stitch 150. So the capacity will be different for them. So that there also I should have the coordinations among all the levels of management. For staffing, the right person I'm choosing, I should have coordination with the employees by knowing their character, by knowing their conditions, everything I should know, and then only the director. So next month directly, coordination needs to be there. Next, motivation, there also coordination should be there with the employees, what they are planning, their requirement that we should know, then only there should be coordination. For controlling also, comparing also, I should have coordination with the employees so that I can get the best work, I can compare and I can control also them. So these are the points of the functions of management. This one, if it is missing also, you cannot achieve your organizational goals in a correct way. Planning, organizing, staffing, directing, motivation, controlling, coordination. Next, we are going to see is subsidiary functions of management. Now, we are going to see subsidiary functions. There are 4 points in subsidiary functions: innovation, representation, decision making, communication. Innovation. Innovation is very, very important, as is there in the subsidiary also. It is there for every company. They should have either innovation. If they are lacking innovation, they cannot survive in the market. Survival of the fittest cannot be done when it is innovation is lacking. What is meaning of innovation? Innovation is creating some new ideas in the business and developing their design or developing their techniques, whatever in form. It can be there for the product. For example, the new cover can be given for a particular biscuit, or any wrapper can be changed, or any quantity can be changed, or the designs, their quality wise, the taste wise, it can be changed. So this all can be done when innovation is there. If innovation is there, they can survive in the market. If they survive in the market, their productions can be, whatever they are doing can be increased because all the products can be easily sold in the market. So when it is sold, again, actually the supply has been done properly, then everywhere the demand will arise. That is, their requirement for the product will arise. So automatically, the innovation can change the older company to the new level of achievement can be done. Example, 100 units, a small manufacturing units is selling at a market per month. Innovation, they are doing, they are changing their wrappers, they are changing their design, they are changing their taste, whatever, anything they are doing. So it can change into 150 also per month. 150 units can also be sold at month. Only because of this innovation. The innovation is there, you can achieve. Next one is representation. Representation is nothing. Representation, every manager should act as a representative of the company. Because he only deals with the customers, he only deals with the government officials, he only deals with the trade unions, he only deals with the workers, supervisors, subordinates. Everywhere, he only acts as the representative. What he should do it? The manager should only properly organize the works and get the works from the employees and give it to the customers. And whatever the documents required by the government also, the manager should keep it at their side and prepare it and ready. So that the manager works only to do all those works. So he only should act as a representative manager. Next is decision making. Decision making is very important that in this case, every person needs to take a decision. They may give you goals. Organization goals can be given by the higher authority. But we should take decision whether how fast we can do it, how much time it will take. So we should decide it. We should take any decision. The employees, every employee should take decision so that only they can achieve their organizational goals given by the higher level. Next is communication. Communication is very important for all the main functions. Where communication needs to be done properly, they can achieve their goals very easily. So communication plays a major role where in the planning, if the MD is planning or managing director is planning, they should inform to the manager. The communication there arises. Organizing, he is dividing the works. It needs to be given to the supervisor and subordinate. So there is a need for the communication. So the communication is there at every level of main function. Main functions, the communication is there properly. If they can achieve their organizational goals. This is the functions of management. So these are the subsidiary functions, innovation, representation, decision making, communication. Let me tell you all the main points for this, keywords for everything, so that it will be easier to get a more marks in your exams. Planning, I have already informed you, deciding in advance is the main point for your planning. In the organizing, he needs to be made accountable. Made accountable. And given authority. Made accountable and given authority. This is the keywords for your organizing. Staffing, choosing the right person for the right job. This is the short keyword for your staffing. Next is directing. Directing means you can direct in guiding, communicating or motivating. By that you can tell directing keywords. Motivation. Motivation in the meaning, he should be given incentives, bonus in the form of monetary or non-monetary forms he can give. So that is the motivation. That is a part of the workers. Next is controlling. Actual performance needs to be compared with the previous year. So to control, make a control of our work. Next is coordination. Coordination, you can tell with all the points. Planning and coordination, organizing and coordination, staffing and coordination, directing and coordination. So all points you can tell. So coordination is there in the every levels of main functions. Next is subsidiary functions keywords. Innovation. Innovation, it is creating new design, new technique, new material, new product. It can be given the keywords. Representation, manager act as a representative. that every manager of the organization should act as a representative. Next is decision making. All the decisions of the company should be taken by the every employees, without involving the employees, you should not take a decision. Every employee should be given opinions or given suggestions while they are taking the decision. So every employee should take their own decision for their working as well as for giving suggestion also. Communication. Communication is a meaning for every levels of paying functions. Communication is very, very important. Their views and opinions should be given to their higher levels so that they may improvise or they may can achieve their goals easily. So these are the functions of management. Main functions we have seen. Subsidiary functions. Main functions: planning, organizing, staffing, directing, motivation, controlling, coordination. Subsidiary functions: innovation, representation, decision making, communication. So these are the functions of management. It is a very, very shortest chapter because only the functions of management you can expect it in the 5 marks, because we have only 4 units under the chapter 1. So you can expect this chapter can be asked in your 5 marks. So give importance to this main function, subsidiary functions, and this main functions will be helpful for your upcoming lessons also. In the last chapter, entrepreneur also, this it is given importance and given words, and you should know the meaning. So give importance to this functions of management. You can expect it in the 5 marks in your board exams. Read well this points whatever I have given you, and make sure that you write your keywords. Whatever I have told you, the keywords is very important for your writing your exams. Give importance to it and write your exams well. Admissions are going through online in our school. You can visit our website www.gkjainschools.org. In the end of the video also I have given some posts, so you can see the number and contact, make a call and contact them. Thanks for watching.